The loft feature in SolidWorks is the command that allows us to create a base, boss, cut, or surface by making transitions between two or more cross-sectional profiles. Common examples are solid transitions between different shapes, for example, a circle and a square, like in the head of a hammer. So let's dive right into the first of the two geometries we will be creating here. This part we see here is a simplified version of the plastic casing of a blender's base. We'll create a rectangle on the bottom plane, then a circle on top of that, and we use the loft function to connect the two. And we'll figure out how to give it the right profile. To do all of this, we create a new part in SolidWorks. We go to Sketch, select Top Plane, create a rectangle that is centered at the origin, and dimension it with 7 and 6 inches. After exiting the sketch, we create a parallel plane with a reference geometry that is parallel to the top plane and offset by 5 inches. On this new plane, we create the sketch of a centered circle 4 inches in diameter, and we can hide the new plane. If we go into loft right away, we can begin to understand what this function does. We click on the rectangle and then the circle, both as the profiles we want to connect, and we get a good preview of what the loft would do. What we get with this is close, but not quite the surface of our final part. If we look at the front face, we notice that the connection between the profiles is a straight line, and we kinda want a surface that is curved along the vertical orientation. To do this, we'll use the second main parameter of the loft function. This parameter is called guide curves. It means that the loft transition will follow the profile of a new sketch. The other ability we have to point here is that the green dots will allow us to manually control the loft. The segment created by these two green points will allow us to tweak the loft itself. But anyways, canceling the loft, we go into Sketch and use the front plane. Inside this plane, we can use the spline segment to connect the rectangular and circular sketches from the side. Every time we left click, we're adding a point that the segment will try to follow by tracing a curved path. Of course, our profile is simpler than that, so we'll only use 3 points for now to give it a similar curved profile. What we can do within the spline command is set the angle of the tangent of the curve at a specific point. For example, if we want the second point, point number 2, to have a tangent at 45 degrees, we can check the tangent driving box and set the angle to 45. The rest of the curve will be adapted by the spline function. Now, what we have in the drawings is a 90 degree angle at the bottom, which is point 3, and a 70 degree angle at the top, which is minus 110 for point 1. And notice that we don't have any other indication. So the point in the middle is restricting the curve more than what we need. So we remove it. With this being done, we can go back to the loft, connect the two first sketches, and add the third new sketch as the guide curve. The loft now follows that guide, but assumes that the other side should also follow it. Since what we want is for this to be symmetric, we cancel this operation, we go back to editing the third sketch, and we create a mirrored spline by creating a center line down the middle and using it within the mirror command. With this new guide curve, we go back again to loft, select the same two sketches to loft, and for the guide curves, we'll select both. Now, this is very important. Every time a sketch is composed of components that are not connected to each other, and we're selecting one of those components separately, as opposed to the entire sketch, SolidWorks will show us this. This tiny window with some selection options shows up to confirm that we only want a component that makes part of a sketch that has other disconnected components, in this case the other disconnected spline. To confirm the selection, acknowledging that you know this segment is part of the larger sketch, we just click on the green checkmark. And we do the same for the one on the right. And now we have the basic shape of what we're looking for. We can add the fillets on all four vertices, set the radius to something reasonable, and click OK. Now, since this is only the plastic cover for the machinery of the blender, we want this to be a shell, not a solid chunk of plastic. But before we do that, we see that we must create a circular hole on that top surface. The top surface we currently have is not the same surface we see at the bottom of the circular hole. If we got rid of the top ring, we would see that our current geometry is missing an extruded hole on the top. We make this hole by selecting the top surface to create a sketch and use the Offset Entities option to offset that circle by 0.12 inches towards the center. This new offset sketch we use to create an extruded cut 0.5 inches deep. And now we can make this chunk of material just a shell. To do that, we use the shell command. We go to Features, we click on Shell, and this practically asks us for A, the plane from where we're gonna start carving out material, meaning that whatever surface we select will have a hole in it, and B, the thickness of our shell. We click on the bottom surface for the first option, and we give it a thickness of 0.12 inches. With this, we are almost finished with our plastic housing for the blender's base. To extrude the ring at the top, we'll use that top surface in the shape of the ring instead of what we did during the last video. During that video, we used that plane to create a sketch, draw a circle, and extrude it. To skip the part where we have to draw two circles in this case and dimension them individually, we can go into Insert, Surface, and Extrude. To select that ring surface, we hold Alt while clicking on that planar face. This way, this ring still has that thickness of 0.12 inches, we set the height to 0.45 inches, we cap the end to make it a solid geometry, delete the original faces, because we don't need them anymore, and knit the result, meaning you're connecting it with the bottom geometry. The tiny hole in the middle, we can make with an extruded cut. Again, this is a greatly simplified version of a plastic housing of a blender's base. Now let's quickly work on a new part to go over a couple of additional concepts. We have this bathtub faucet that appears to be created by lofting three profiles. One horizontal circle, one vertical rectangle, and a straight slot angled at 45 degrees. We'll begin by creating the horizontal circle. We create a sketch on the top plane with a circle that is located 4 inches away from the origin, 1 inch in diameter, and while we're here, we'll draw a vertical center line at the origin for reference. We now create a sketch on the right plane that contains a rectangle aligned vertically with the origin with a base of 1 inch and a height of 1.5 inches, whose center is located 2.25 inches above the origin. For the slanted sketch of the straight slot, we'll create a reference geometry plane using the top plane and the center line we drew within the first sketch to create a plane angled at 45 degrees. On this plane, we create a sketch of a straight slot with a vertical line and for now any size, and we dimension it to be 0.5 inches long and have a radius of 0.5 inches. We align it vertically with anything else, and then if we pay attention to this slot's center line, we see that its center is coincident with the upper part of the circle in the background. So we select the center of the slot and the circle behind it, and set that to have a coincident relation. Now we clearly need a guide curve for the bottom curved surface, and I say clearly because first, there's no way this curved line is the default, most straightforward way SolidWorks is gonna assume the transition, and second, we are given some information here and here. The top curve seems to not need the guide though. For the bottom curve, we go into Sketch, select the front plane, and use a spline to connect the bottom side. We set point 1's tangent to have a 170 degree angle, supplementary angle of 10, and point 3's tangent to be minus 90 degrees. We exit the sketch, we go into Features, select Loft, under Profile select the three sketches, and under Guide Curve, the sketch we just drew. After clicking OK, we go into the Shell feature, and in this case, we select both the rectangle and the circle, so that both of these surfaces are open. We input 0.12 inches as the thickness, and we click OK. And we're done. We have our faucet using three profiles and one guide curve. You can check out the links to the other lectures of the SolidWorks CAD course in the description below. Down there, you can find the links to the playlists of other engineering courses too. Thanks for watching!